Bishop, a sad but beautiful feast connected to jealousy, anger, selfishness today, the Feast of the Holy Innocents.
Yes, the whole story in the Gospels of King Herod being so threatened by the word of mouth that a Messiah is coming, is about to be born, that he perpetrates this egregious, horrific act of multiple serial murderers of infants. And just the horrific, so often caught in art, the horrific experience of mothers at the murder of their children. And it's a very, very powerful feast. It has a lot of contemporary relevance.
Absolutely. I mean, not only to all of the parents out there, like my mom and dad, who lost a child, there's something today for you in this as well, but also in our whole pro-life position as people of God, right?
So true, Monsignor. In New York State, it's the tragic truth and reality that we have a so-called Reproductive Health Act that permits not only abortion to the moment of birth, but forms of infanticide after birth. How can that possibly be the case? We know that the sanctity as Catholics in the living in the public square, that the sanctity of life is the foundation of all other human rights. When the sanctity of life is attacked in the way it's attacked in New York State by the Reproductive Health Act, all other rights begin to crumble and to erode. It is so important on this Feast of the Holy Innocents for each one of us to take stock of our lives, to see, are we really witnessing to the sanctity of human life, or are we cowering in a corner? John Cardinal O'Connor used to say that the index of an effective witness to the gospel of life is the carrying of a cross. If we're carrying a cross in our witness, that's a good sign that we're witnessing vibrantly, consistently, courageously, and heroically.
And we're grateful today for their presence in heaven and the presence of all those who have been lost, all the children who have been lost in many, many different ways in heaven today.
Okay.
The Holy Innocents,
pray for us.
Pray for us.